So I'm here with Eric Kim, and Eric has an awesome tool called Twyla, and I've been using it for two or three years now?
Yeah.
Maybe two or three years now?
Yeah.
And Eric and I have been in touch. We've actually, we went to Rush a couple of weeks ago. We hung out at Rush. That was awesome.
Excellent. Yeah.
You know? And so, you know, Eric and I are just having a quick chat right now, saying hi. You know, he's got family. I have family. We're checking in, seeing how things are going. And I thought it might be useful to ask Eric about, you know, what is Twyla? Why should people use it? You know, for nonprofits actually who are using Twitter right now.
So a great question, John, and thanks so much for connecting today. I really appreciate it. So you know, in a nutshell, if you're on Twitter, let's say you're a nonprofit or you work in a nonprofit and you're on Twitter, the goal of being on Twitter really is to be able to get a message out there, and the message. Typically is the message that you want to convey, what you're about or what your mission is, right? And so, you know, as users get onto Twitter, whether you're a nonprofit or not, you start tweeting content that you think is interesting to your audience, you think it means something to you. And after a while, you start realizing a couple of things. One is that the content has a very short life on Twitter. So you're tweeting, and then within an hour, basically that's gone, right? And if people haven't responded to it within an hour, there's very little likelihood that they'll ever find that tweet. That's one of the aspects. The other aspect that you get to realize over time is that because you're engaging in this mechanism of posting this information in real time, you're not necessarily doing it in a very deliberate fashion and in a themed fashion. And so if you're a nonprofit and you're about three different things or two things, right? Do you know if those are the things you talk about the most, right? And so what Twyla is a mechanism that allows you to capture all of the Twitter content you've put out there, all the stuff that's way past an hour long. It automatically pulls it together, organizes it by the themes you talk about the most on Twitter, and creates a beautiful website out of it that's topically organized.
Mm.
So that now your audience can see your content even if it's more than an hour old. They see it more visually, and they see it organized thematically. And thematically meaning, you know, organized around the topics you talk about the most.
Mm-hmm.
The side benefit of organizing all this information into these topical pages is that now these tweets that are long gone in the Twitter ecosystem can now be found on search engines because these pages get indexed on the search engines. That's one of the things that this application does really well. So the beauty of all of this is it does it all automatically. You really don't have to do anything as your user. You just connect your Twitter account, and it creates these pages.
Mm-hmm.
Now the thing is, you know, when people look at their pages the first time or they look at them over a period of time, they start realizing that because they're not tweeting necessarily very deliberately or they don't necessarily have a very solid strategy as to what they post, that what they tweet about is not necessarily exactly what they want to be known for. And so this is where we're putting our efforts in now, is really giving you, the Twitter publisher, a tool set that allows you to get the feedback to understand what is it you're tweeting about, to allows you to define what are the things you want to be known for, and grades you vis-a-vis those things. And then on those topics that you want to be known for, but that maybe you haven't been tweeting so much about, we even suggest content that you can tweet out so that basically you can put out more of your expertise out there.
Hmm. Wow, okay. So Eric, I'm looking at my Twyla page, right? And so if I'm, you know, just for everybody who's watching this video and or they're not familiar with Twyla, it is super easy to sign up. And this is kind of the landing page or the simple page that Eric's discussing or was talking about organizing all your tweets by topic. Okay, so as you can see, on my Twyla page, it says, you know, Facebook, how-to, Facebook page, fundraising, social media. I mean, those are the topics that I'm, according to Twyla, tweeting about the most. And that's good because those are the topics that I actually want to be known for. Okay, I mean, we could swap out Facebook page for nonprofit. That would be great. But it informs me kind of a slight direction I might want to go in terms of being known for on Twitter, right? The other benefit that I heard you say, Eric, not now, but a while ago, is that it basically gives your tweets a little bit more life or more, it lengthens their life and also has a direct impact on search engine optimization, particularly for tweets that are linked to an organization's website.
Correct, correct. So all the work that you're now doing on Twitter isn't just for the sake of being on Twitter and just for that 1 hour of engagement you get on each tweet, but you're actually contributing towards your search engine optimization efforts every time you tweet when you have a Twilio page. So one of the things that we allow our users to do is to host their page, their Twilio page, on their domain, so that all of a sudden all of this Twitter content you've put out there becomes part of your body of work that Google, people that go on Google to search for things can find, and it gets indexed there really, really well.
Oh,
so now you start getting additional traffic to that engages with your Twitter content that people that would have never seen it before.
Well, so actually, on my Twilio page, I haven't done that yet. So it's not a subdomain of johnhayden.com. It's just twilio.com/johnhayden. But if I have it as kind of sitting on my site, that actually improves my site's ability to show up in search because there are just a sheer amount of inbound links. Would that be fair to say? Like the number of inbound links increase.
Yeah, there's a several-fold SEO benefit. One is the fact that if you host it on your domain, now you're increasing your footprint on Google much more significantly just by virtue of including your Twitter content as well as content. So what we see oftentimes is when it's a blogger, we'll see that their page maybe has 200, 300 pages indexed on Google.
Mm-hmm.
Now all of a sudden they add their Twilio page to their site, and all of a sudden it goes up into the thousands because now all of a sudden you've got hundreds if not thousands of topically organized pages of content, great content you put on Twitter that would have just disappeared otherwise.
Wow, that's amazing. And all those topically organized pages are automatically built by Twilio.
Automatically built for you. It's very hands off. Now there are tools we can give you to actually give you a little more control over it. But basically, you can be as hands off as you want, and it does it automatically for you.
Mm.
Yeah.
Great. So I guess people just go to Twilio, sign up, and that's it, and they're good to go.
Yeah. Right. Twilio.com. Request an invite. We're still in a beta phase, but we do grant requests to almost everyone. If you don't get your page within a couple of days, just tweet us or email us, and we'll get it turned around for you.
Beautiful. And I'll put all that stuff below the video.